Hi, everyone. My name is Katherine Hartley, and I've been with Adobe for, as Jim said, 3 years now, almost, as the executive assistant for Duncan Egan, VP of APAC and Japan Marketing, located at our Sydney office. And I would like to give a shout out to all of our culturally diverse Adobe EAs out there. You are all amazing. Now, when I was 10 years old, my family immigrated to Sydney, Australia from the Philippines. Like most immigrant families, my parents worked very hard to put a huge emphasis in getting a good education. And while my sister excelled at school, I can honestly say that I did okay. I tried to follow my sister's footsteps by taking the same subjects like maths and chemistry, which, by the way, self-confessed, I hated. Out of desperation, I once cheated on a chemistry assessment, and I got caught. But that turned out to be a turning point for me because my teacher pointed out, if you follow your footstep, if you follow everything your sister did, you're never going to know what you're good at. So for that moment, I realized that I was actually failing myself by living someone else's dream. So after high school, I started working, married my husband, who I've been with since high school, and we had two boys, NJ and Austin. Life was absolutely perfect. But soon after NJ's birth, I could tell something just wasn't quite right. He seems to be always hitting his head on tables, tripping on things, and misjudging his surroundings. And as his mother, with him 24/7, I thought there was more to it than just clumsiness. I thought perhaps he needed glasses. But being so young, they can't really test babies until they're about 2 years old. So we waited. And when he was two, we saw the first of what would be many pediatric ophthalmologists. The doctors told me that NJ was very nearsighted, news that I didn't expect. His left eye had only a fraction of a vision of what normal people would have. And his right eye, well, that wasn't much better. Basically, he couldn't see beyond the tip of his nose, and everything was a blur. As shocked as we were, I felt relieved that we got a professional diagnosis. The doctor prescribed him very thick glasses and asked me to regularly put a patch on one eye to strengthen the weaker eye. And so I became a mom on a mission. I was determined to help my son improve his vision by doing exactly what the doctors asked. Every day we'd do the patch treatment. Even though I knew how much he hated it, it frightened him. He'd sit in the same spot, barely moving all day. It made me feel like such a bad mother. But I felt obligated to follow the doctor's advice. So after 8 months of this, we made a horrible discovery. Rather than strengthening NJ's weaker eye, the patch treatment made his vision worse. Much worse. And in addition, they just casually said that NJ might eventually go blind and that there was little that they could do. I felt so angry, so betrayed. And as his mother, I wasn't prepared to sit there and just watch him lose his sight. I had to do something. So after numerous doctors' visits, we found a doctor who diagnosed NJ with severe pathological myopia. The doctor advised me that his condition was rare and that there was no cure, and suggested that I should try finding alternative treatments. Now, the girl who failed chemistry was about to learn everything she could about ophthalmology. I would be lying to you if I didn't tell you that I was scared to death. I didn't know how to find alternative treatments. I didn't know where to start, because I didn't know what I was looking for. Now, this was the year 2000, the millennium. For those of you who remember, there was no Google, there was no YouTube, and barely internet. So I emailed, I faxed, I posted letters to universities, specialists, and medical schools asking for help. Some replied. Some said I was absolutely crazy. And others dismissed by suggesting that I had no medical qualifications. And you know what? They were right, because I'm just a mom asking for someone to help. So I persisted because I couldn't afford to waste time. At any given time, I knew NJ's brain could potentially shut down his eyesight, leave him completely blind. And from that point, there's no turning back. I was desperate. Finding a cure was my only solution. It was my only hope. And one day, I finally did. I came across a doctor who was participating in an FDA clinical trial in the US for severe myopia on adults. Even though no child has gone through that surgery before, something told me that we were on the right track. But let me tell you, it wasn't an easy process. It required special approval through international review boards, endless examinations, and tons of paperwork. But our hard work paid off. We finally got the approval to do the surgery, which would implant an intraocular lens in NJ's left eye. And as you can probably imagine, I was so excited and I was so relieved. But believe it or not, there were many in the medical community who did not approve of this approach. And as a matter of fact, NJ's primary doctor called to tell me, "If you decide to go ahead with this surgery, you may as well put his eyes in the bucket." I was devastated. I cried my eyes out. I couldn't believe the complete lack of empathy. After all that, what we've been through. But he wasn't going to break me, because I wasn't ready to give up. So of course there were more hurdles to overcome before the surgery. First, we had to raise money with the support of our family, our friends, and our community. Then we were scheduled to go to the US in September 2001, when 9/11 happened. And of course that tragedy took precedence. All flights were cancelled and we had no choice but to postpone the surgery. So I began to doubt if ever it was going to happen. I started thinking that maybe it just wasn't meant to be. But it was. NJ had the implant surgery on October 2001 when he was 3 years old. I was terrified, I was excited, but deep down I so desperately hoped that this surgery would be the answers to our prayers. The day after the surgery, I held my breath as the doctor examined his eyes. The child who could not see beyond the tip of his nose was finally able to identify pictures projected on the wall. A banana, a cake, glasses, and a bird. Words that signaled the beginning of a whole new life for NJ. A life with normal vision, and we were forever grateful that NJ was given the gift of sight. And I am so proud to tell you, NJ is now 22 years old and a freelance videographer. He lives and breathes his craft in telling his story by using none other than Adobe's Creative Cloud. So to say that this journey had made me more confident would be the understatement. This experience taught me that I can accomplish far more than I could ever realize. I was resilient enough to bounce back after multiple disappointments. I was confident enough to overcome negative interactions with medical professionals who doubted me. And I was smart enough to find the treatment to save my son's sight. I'm just a mom that made the impossible possible. Thank you.